Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and we're back again with three exciting SpaceX updates for you. Let's start with our Starship update, as SpaceX carries out static fire of SN10 Starship prototype. On the 25th of February 2021, SpaceX has again fired up Raptor engines of Starship Serial Number 10, or SN10, prototype for the second time at SpaceX's South Texas site near Boca Chica Village on the Gulf Coast. At 5:57 Eastern Standard Time, Starship SN10 ignited its three Raptor engines for a few seconds. This way, the company, SpaceX, moves ahead for Starship's pre-launch procedures. On the 23rd of February, SN10 had performed its first static fire. On getting an anomaly with one of the vehicle's Raptor engines, SpaceX team at that instant swapped that engine out. To quote SpaceX CEO Elon Musk on Twitter, "One of the engines is suspect, so we're swapping it out." And then SpaceX made SN10 to go towards another static fire. Chris B. of NASASPACEFLIGHT tweeted on the 25th of February 2021, "Static fire! Starship SN10 fires up her three engines after a record Raptor swap turnaround. The big question is if it was a good test. If so, the launch could be just days away. Mary, Boca Chica Gale, and the bot's views." If SpaceX finds that the results of the second static fire has gone well, then very soon we can see SN10 roaring into the skies. Starship SN10's high-altitude flight will be the same with its predecessors. Last two flights of SN8 and SN9 performed very well in their startup, ascent, descent, belly flop, and flip maneuver, but they failed to land. Upon landing, both of them were turned into exploding massive fireballs, as the touchdown was too fast. By 2023, Starship will regularly ferry humans across space, according to Musk. "Now it's for us to see how this SN10 performs. We all hope to see the landing of SN10. Let us move to the next segment to quickly take a look at how Musk switched to the second position on the world's top billionaire list. A single tweet causes Musk to lose billions of dollars. SpaceX and Tesla owners again moved to the second position in the Bloomberg Billionaires Index. Just a few days ago, Elon Musk regained his title of the world's richest person after his aerospace company, SpaceX, completed another funding round. SpaceX funding round had set Musk back in his position and pushed him at the very top of the Bloomberg Billionaires Index. Musk's net worth at the time was appropriated at $199.9 billion after SpaceX has successfully completed its latest funding round. But now, Musk's net worth has fallen by almost more than $15 billion. The price of the shares of Musk's electric car company, Tesla Inc., fell by 8.6% on the 22nd of February after his tweet on Bitcoin prices. Musk's present worth is $183.4 billion. Jeff Bezos, owner and CEO of Amazon, had again revived the title of the world's richest person, as the prices of shares of Elon Musk's electric car company, Tesla, went down. Musk is now switched to second position in the billionaire list, and his net worth has again got down. Earlier, also, Musk had been switched to the second position when Tesla shares went down, but SpaceX's funding round had changed the scene. A group of investors who were led by Sequoia Capital awarded SpaceX $850 million. According to the index, the round values the company at $74 billion in August last year, which is a direct jump of 60% from August to now. A sum of nearly $11 billion got added to Musk's net worth at that time. The tweet, which cost Musk such a loss, was a reply from Elon Musk to Peter Schiff. Musk had written in Twitter, "An email saying you have gold is not the same as having gold. You might as well have crypto. Money is just data that allows us to avoid the inconvenience of barter. That data, like all data, is subject to latency and error. The system will evolve to that which minimizes both." In a tweet on February 20th, 2021, Musk wrote, "That said, BTC, Bitcoin, and ETH, Ethereum, do seem high, LOL. 12:32 p.m. Tesla had earlier announced that it has invested $1.5 billion in the Bitcoin cryptocurrency. The announcement led to a huge sweep in the price of one Bitcoin, which has crossed the level of $50,000 per coin. Tesla had said it would also start receiving Bitcoin as a mode of payment for their products in the future. Tesla owner Elon Musk has earlier bought Dogecoin, another cryptocurrency, for his son. Earlier, Musk triggered a rise in Dogecoin's price with a tweet, "Doge." Now, Bezos is holding the first position in Bloomberg Billionaires Index with a net worth of $186.3 billion, though he suffered some billions of financial losses. Let's move to our last segment of news, as SpaceX states heat damage as cause of Falcon 9 booster landing anomaly. On the 23rd of February 2021, Hans Konigsmann, SpaceX's Vice President of Mission Assurance, said during a session of the 47th Spaceport Summit that the landing anomaly of last Starlink mission is under thorough investigation. He also specified heat damage as the reason for Falcon 9 booster landing failure after its Starlink launch conducted on the 15th of February. "This has to do with heat damage, but it's a running investigation," said Konigsmann. He later added that SpaceX is close to nailing it down and taking preventative measures. However, Konigsmann is confident that the boosters can be reused for 10 or more times. The booster that failed to land on the 15th of February mission was covering its sixth launch. Till SpaceX has reflown boosters up to 8 times, Konigsmann further said that SpaceX will launch a booster for a 9th time in the upcoming weeks. "We're learning a lot about refurbishment, and we're learning where the areas are where we need to pay attention to. We've been learning with every single landing," Konigsmann said. He further said, "We will continue to look at that booster and make an assessment whether we can move forward with it." Till now, SpaceX hasn't conducted any Falcon 9 launch since that failed landing of booster. According to a report, on the 28th of February, SpaceX will attempt the next launch of Starlink satellites. The failed landing of the booster broke the series record of 24 successful landings of Falcon 9 boosters. According to SpaceX's official webcast, Falcon 9 booster was descending at a higher speed than normal and thus receiving a bit more heat than it was configured for. Wayne Monteith, Associate Administrator for Commercial Space Transportation at the Federal Aviation Administration, said at the Spaceport Summit panel discussion, "This is what we call a successful failure. It failed within the safety regime, and they protected the public and protected public property. For us, even when a system does not meet all mission goals, as long as it fails safely, in many respects, that's progress. Each of these flights demonstrates something new and allows industry to move forward." On the 19th of February, at a briefing, Joel Montalbano, NASA International Space Station Program Manager, said NASA is consulting with SpaceX about that investigation of landing failure to look for any anomaly that could pose serious threat to the Crew 2 commercial crew launch scheduled for the 20th of April. "As of today, we're working with them to better understand what happened. And right now, it's just too early to say we're going to have any impacts." Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.